to my channel. It's Mae Larson here. So glad that you can join me. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so. And for this tutorial, we're going to be creating some Halloween apothecary bottles using Dollar Tree bottles. I have also purchased some other bottles from Hobby Lobby, and you will see that in this tutorial. Now, you're going to be needing some chalk paint, and I purchased this bottle from Walmart's Waverly Matte Finish Ink Color. And you'll need Mod Podge. You will also need some Michael's Recollection Halloween die cuts. And don't forget to use your 40% coupon. That is very important, ladies. Also, one of the things that I have not mentioned here is you're going to be needing some DecoArt metallic rubs. And these were gifted to me by Young Sue. And I believe she purchased those at Joann's. You can use basically any metallic rub, but I use the DecoArt, and they work really nicely, especially with baby wipes. So what you're going to do is you're going to apply an even coat of this Waverly ink chalk paint on your bottles. You are going to let it dry completely. One of the things that I have noticed with this brand is that you totally need to let it dry fully before you give it a second coat. If you try to go in there and speed through, and you know, I'm notorious for this, I know we are always impatient, but if you try to go back in while it's still wet to give it a second layer, you're gonna end up rubbing off the under layer. So just let it sit for a couple, I would say about an hour. I'm always impatient, so oftentimes I will take the heat gun, but just know that if you are going to do that, don't go too close because it'll bubble up. Now, this is a matte finish, and if you notice on the picture, it is glossy. That's because I sealed it with some Mod Podge. So go ahead and give your bottles a good two layers of chalk paint and come back and meet me for the second step. Distressing my die cuts from Recollection, and I'm using Tim Holtz Vintage Photos to do this. And go ahead and do that to all your little embellishment pieces. And once you have selected all the pieces, set them aside, and then we will come in and start Mod Podging those onto the bottles. But the first thing is we need to distress these with some type of vintage ink or any type of ink of your choice. So now we're going to start applying our Mod Podge to our die cuts, and what I do is I do the back of the embellishment piece and on the surface where I'm going to decoupage, just so that the surface is prepared for what I'm about to place on top. As you can see, I'm using my fingers. I'm not using any burnishing tool just because I don't want to tear my embellishment die cut. So be very gentle on this process. It's not like you are rubbing on paper. You just don't want to break your embellish die cut. So I'm just using my fingers to burnish. And since I will be using Mod Podge for sealing the entire bottle, I'm not too concerned about the seepage of the Mod Podge, but you can wipe off any leakage if you don't want a shiny surface. But you want to start from the center out to get any air bubbles that you might have on your die cuts. So go ahead and do this to all your pieces. And once you have all your pieces glued down, we will proceed forward. So that is what the bottle looks like once we have applied the die cuts with the Mod Podge, and I've also sealed the bottle with some Mod Podge. Now you're going to want to do this to all your pieces. You're also going to take all your wood pieces, and that's a candlestick from Hobby Lobby, from the unpainted wood section, and a knob also from Hobby Lobby. And we're going to paint all those pieces and start assembling them towards the end. You will see that. So just make sure that you paint all your unfinished wood pieces. And basically what we are creating is some finial type of element for our bottle. Unpainted wood disc. You can purchase these at either Michael's or Hobby Lobby. I happened to forget to pick these up when I went to Hobby Lobby, so when I was at Michael's I picked those up. So you want to paint them front and back, and it just kind of gives that eye-catching feel that if you turn the bottle upside down, completely finished. I just have a thing about crossing my T's and dotting my I's whenever necessary. So you don't have to paint both sides, but it's just I'm finicky about those kind of things. So if you want, paint both sides. If you don't, just don't. But you'll also want to apply some Mod Podge to seal this in. Now for this bottle, I am using some Graphic Digital Designs from Victoria Designs, and I will put the link below. And I used several of her designs on three of the bottles, so I will make sure that I put the link below so you can check out her Etsy store and purchase these graphics. I also use vintage photos to distress the cutouts. Now I went ahead and printed these on printer paper. Didn't use cardstock, just went right straight to the printer paper and printed those on. Once you have it all distressed, you can then take your Mod Podge and do the same thing. Apply some to the back of the image and some to the surface to make sure it adheres. And be very gentle when applying your Mod Podge and burnishing it, because it will tear, so just be very, very careful. Now, another idea that you can do is if you have a Xyron machine, you might want to run these through if you want to. I just have a love-hate relationship with Xyron because sometimes the surface doesn't stick as well, and so I rather just get it done and over with and apply some Mod Podge. Plus, I like the after effect of knowing that it's completely sealed in. We're going to grab a metal embellishment that I had in my stash, and I'm also going to take the chalk paint and apply it to the metal embellishment. And you can do this with any metal embellishment that you may have if you want to change a color, or you can use also gesso, black gesso or white gesso, whichever you want to use, depending on what type of surface you're working on. So if you want to use black gesso, you can use black gesso. If you want to use white gesso, you can use white gesso. In this particular case, I'm just using straight chalk paint from Waverly Walmart brand, and it worked pretty fine. design labels that I printed out on printer paper. And I'm just going to go ahead and distress some of those with the vintage photos from Tim Holtz. And I went ahead and printed those right off on printer paper. Once you have those distressed, go ahead and adhere it to your bottles as well. Just gives it a nice glossy finish, and also makes it a little bit easier when you're rubbing on your metallics. I found that it was a lot easier to rub the metallic on and wipe it off, a lot easier by doing the sealing with the Mod Podge. So go ahead and do that. It gives it really nice texture effect when you're doing the metallics as well. Other embellishments I'm going to apply. Now this is a Hobby Lobby bottle that I picked up during their 75% clearance, and I'm just figuring out with the Recollection Halloween die cuts which ones to adhere to this bottle. So go ahead and play around with your pieces and figure out what you're going to put on your bottle. Take your Mod Podge, and as I had stated before, the reason why my bottles are so glossy and not so matte, I didn't like the matte finish, so I just went ahead and did a brush stroke or even brush layer of Mod Podge throughout my bottles. And not only did it make it easier when I was applying the wax, but it just gave it a nice clean polish look, and that's what it looks like once you have done the Mod Podge effect on it. It's very glossy, very smooth. You can see. I like the effects of it better. Now you're going to take your E6000 and you're going to take all your wood pieces and start assembling those with E6000. And this particular E6000 was the one that was black. And it did take a little bit longer to dry up, but I think that's common for a lot of the E6000. Now, you want to work in a very well ventilated area when working with E6000. And if you don't want to work with E6000, there's also Quick Grip that you can purchase at Hobby Lobby. Eric just kind of happened to purchase this for me really quick because I needed E6000, and Walmart was a lot quicker for him to stop up and or stop by and pick this up for me. But typically I like to use Quick Grip. It's fast drying and you don't have the fumes that you get from E6000. Piece that I have embellished. I'm also going to use the E6000, and I'm also going to take some twine, or you can also take a rubber band and just kind of hold it in place, because again, E6000 takes a bit to dry up, so I just used twine that I had and held it in place. Now here's the DecoArt metallic rub. And you're going to want to do this all over the bottle, especially around the edges and corners. And I found that you can also take some baby wipe and wipe it if you have too much. And it just makes it a lot easier with that sealant from the Mod Podge. Now this is a Tim Holtz Halloween embellishment that I placed there. And I had done this in the video tutorial on Friday, but I didn't like the way it looked with the twine, so I just kind of removed the twine and glued the skull back in. So this is just fixing the bottle from Friday. I wasn't too happy with how it looked, so I just kind of redid a few little things on the bottle. So it's the same bottle, just kind of redid some of this. Now this is more of Tim Holtz's embellishments for Halloween, and I've taken a couple of these embellishments and with some twine I have attached it to the bottles, and now that's another one that we were working on Friday. And I used the white frost from DecoArt that Young Su had gifted me, and again I'm just tying it with some twine that I purchased at Dollar Tree, and you can get 3 spools of twine for $1, so that is not a bad deal at all. So run over to your Dollar Tree and grab yourself one of these twines because they're very useful. some finishing touches, make a little bow with your twine on this smaller bottle that I purchased from Hobby Lobby. And you can see all the embellishments I have placed. Now this is just a little bead that I place in the center of that flower. And I just use some hot glue to place it down for quick adhering to the metal. If you have patience, you can use E6000. I just didn't have patience. I'll be honest. I do not have patience. But you guys already know that. I like to hurry up and get the job done. So, there's the end result. I think it looks very stinking cute. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Make sure that if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do so. Let me know what you think about this tutorial, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.